But before I actually finish here, what I'm going to do next is to, because we're still in the chroot environment, I'm going to install the four utilities that I usually install to enable me to have network access and to download files from the new environment. Otherwise, it's quite hard. In that, yes, I'll be able to download packages because we'll have FTP. But it's hard to get the commands in accurately. Certainly won't be able to cut and paste. I'd have to type them in manually, as there's no servers at all to log into this machine on LFS 5.0. So what I'm going to do now is to go back to the sources, create a BLFS directory, change into it, and recall that Lynx command that I didn't need in the end. Yes, I need to do this outside, of course. So let's come out, cd lfs sources blfs, and recall the Lynx command there. And I'm going to go into this blfs directory here and download each one of these files, because these are all the files that I need. So basically, there is a blfs 5, which is the first, it's the second BLFS that was published, but it's the first one that actually tracks the version of it is actually the same. It tracks the same or the equivalent version of Linux from scratch. So if you see, for example, beyond Linux from scratch 9.5 or something, there'll be a Linux from scratch 9.5 that goes with that BLFS 9.5. So this is actually BLFS 5 this is taken from. So I want to download these packages and save them to disk. And I believe these are available on the internet on a mirror or a repository somewhere. All of the BLFS, I think, as I remember. Let's look for that. BLFS 5.0. Yeah, it looks like somebody's uploaded that too. I didn't find this one previously. I did find an ordinary BLFS mirror. So yeah, it looks like somebody's put every single file on the Internet Archive, which is a great service to the community, I think. Looks like they're all packaged up in one tarball there as well, including the Learn some scratch packages as well, so that might be the place to go to fetch everything if you wanted to build Linux from scratch 5. I didn't have plans on building beyond Linux from scratch at all. In fact, I didn't have plans on building the subsequent versions of the Linux from scratch 1, but I thought, oh, it would be interesting to see what a slightly later one would be like. And somebody actually asked me if I would be building beyond Linux from scratch 6.3 specifically, and I think that might be a good version to build beyond Linux from scratch from, good early version. It should be reasonably mature, and yet not too recent to be sufficiently different from modern packages. So it's something I think I might, well, I'm certainly considering it. Whether I'll actually do it or not, I can't say for certain, but I think I'd like to. I think that would be quite an interesting project to do. So yeah, the BLFS packages are available online, like I say. So what I need to do next is to come out of this, go back into the chroot, double check that hasn't got the tools anywhere. No, cd back to sources, BLFS, and those files should be there now. Yep. So the next thing I need to do is to go into Beyond Linux from scratch, which I'm not sure if I've got it on my server. Let's look for BLFS Museum. Oh, looks like the mirror server. Yeah, it's on here on the mirror service. So let's go back home and let's look for the first one I need to build is OpenSSH. And sorry, not OpenSSH, OpenSSL. So let's build that one first. Then I'll do OpenSSH. But I want to do the server in case I couldn't find any telnet daemon on here. I didn't look too closely, but there was nothing obvious. So whether it's part of another package, I don't know. But I decided to install the SSH daemon server on here. And I still couldn't access it from any modern machine. But with a fix, I could access it from this Linux from scratch 10 that I've got running on the Pentium Pro server. So I'll show you that fix in case that's of any use. OpenSSH as a server. What else do I need? Wget. And finally, links. So I'll install all of these. Is that going to go? No, it's not. So I'll start with OpenSSL. Start with extracting it. XJ. Right, okay. Back to the land of different archives. So in the BLFS book, they tend to lump all the commands together in one go. So it's less of a learning experience with Beyond Linux scratch. It still is, but the fact they lump all these commands together, there is descriptions about some of the information that's put in here. So this takes about 20 odd minutes to compile, I think, as I remember. Right, so that has built. Looks like we make. Is that installed? Make. Yeah, it looks like it's done everything, including installing. Yes, it has. And this just describes the commands. Okay, so that's done. That's that. So I'm going to do OpenSSH next. So that's a gzip. Okay, I've got some setup here, including obviously creating a user because we're going to be running the server. And we configure, make, install with these commands. And I think this takes about 10 to 15 minutes or so. Okay, so that's installed. Going to be running server, so we need this init script. One thing I will do in the SSHD config is to allow root access, because I want to ensure that we can get in with root. Although we've got an LFS user, arguably that's temporary. So let's allow root access. So it's hashed out there, roomed out. So I assume the default then would be to be no. So I'll remove that to allow root access. And then we'll create this init script. And then create these links to allow that to be called at various run levels. So that's OpenSSH done. So go back to sources, BLFS, and tidy that up. And now we'll do wget. And that's fairly straightforward. And this takes about 3 minutes or so, 3-4 minutes. Okay, so that's done. Just to test it, perhaps we could download one of these files, a small one maybe. Can I click on that? No. So this would test the wget functionality works, and it would also test the HTTPS part as well. So if I copy that link address, it's only 1.6k, this file. So let's copy this. In fact, the should work like that. Oh, right, there's no resolve. .org, so it was resolve.conf, so I'm going to create that now. Resolve.conf and just put name server 192.168.0.8 for my own name server and domain mynet.org. Let's retry that, that's better. Right, the SSL connection hasn't worked. It could be that it's out of date, that's a possibility. Or it's a SSL feature that's not working, so that is a possibility. So maybe of limited use. I'll have to retry that when I've rebooted in case it's anything to do with the fact we're in chroot. So I'll tidy that up and finish off by installing Lynx. And just paste all these in, and this takes about 10-12 minutes or so. Okay, that's done. I'll have a go at testing this. I'm not sure if it will work. Let's, for example, put that in. No, I wonder if the SSL encryption being used is not compatible. Maybe it's too old a version. But anyway, the connection to the server I've got should be fine. Yeah, that's working fine. So that is that. That's all I'm going to install from BLFS. So it's just purely to allow me to get onto the network to install the next version to allow it to be easier to do. Yeah, there's not much else to do then. Let's get rid of that. Just move on to the end. So it says if you're planning, oh yes, this is the stripping. So you need to make sure you log out. So we need to unmount everything we've mounted first of all from within the chroot. So I'm going to unmount boot. Unmount slash dev slash pts and proc. Now I'm going to do the logout and looks like I need to chroot back in. Again, this time with the tools and then run the command to strip. Keep my fingers crossed. This has always been successful before where I've done this. So it's probably not really necessary. I have had trouble with it before. I'm never sure why. It's probably files that are still open, maybe. But I can't ever remember having problems with Linux from scratch 5. Okay, that's done. The last thing to do is to make this version file and get ready to reboot. Okay, looks like we should have unmounted those file systems now. Hopefully it's not made any problems. Unmount LFS and we can reboot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shut down and halt the computer and then set up the video for looking at the actual screen of the machine rather than looking at it remotely so that we can see the grub boot menu and see it boot and well, see how it boots. So I'll shut down there now, log out the remote computer that I piggyback off, and when I come back it'll be on the actual terminal itself.